Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
Well, there are all sorts of negative stories about hypnosis, the Manchurian candidate types of scenarios. I would imagine, to the extent that it is a powerful psychological tool, and the research is quite extraordinary, it's one of, I think, the most powerful tools we have, it probably does have negative applications.
Well, anything positive can have a negative application. The example I often use is psychedelics. Psychedelics are useful for many things and helpful for many, many people. They also have a negative side. For some people, they can throw them into psychosis, or they can cause extreme psychological damage.
No.
In hypnosis, in the hands of a qualified practitioner, I make the point that hypnosis is perfectly safe. With an unqualified practitioner, or with a malevolent practitioner, yes, hypnosis can be used very, very negatively. And again, when I say hypnosis reaches the ability the person has to imagine something, if a hypnotist were having them imagine something very, very negative, or actually very, very harmful, they might indeed do this.
Mm-hmm.
By and large, a person will not do something against their ethical code. But let's say a person has a very fragile or even negative ethical code. A malevolent practitioner could very easily cause them to create a crime of some sort, a very serious crime under the influence of hypnosis.
Or could create a scenario where they don't realize what they're doing.
That's right. They could do something negative, like harming a person or even robbing a bank, mm-hmm. thinking that this was part of a movie script or a movie scenario. Mm-hmm. Of course, this only applies to that very small percentage of people who are highly hypnotizable.
Mm-hmm.
And as my dear friend Ted Barber once demonstrated, there are three types of highly suggestible people. One is the hallucinatory people, who are actually hallucinating under hypnosis,
mm-hmm.
and who are actually, these are the people that see things that are not there or hear things that are not happening.
Yeah.
The other ones are the high fantasy people, who have the ability to fantasize something. Yeah, they know this is a fantasy, but it's something they can allow themselves to believe in temporarily.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third type is the highly motivated person who wants to be hypnotized so badly that they will go along with what the hypnotist says and comply as tightly and as closely as they can.
Mm-hmm.
Those are highly hypnotizable people. Hypnosis virtuosos is
well,
called.
What percentage of the population would you say are hypnosis?
Less than 10%.
Uh-huh.
Yes.